Hello students, today we will continue lesson 4, log on to animate CC. So in this lesson we will continue from the topic menu. So this menu provides control over common functions like opening of the file, means opening of the document, and the closing of the document and the saving of the document. And also we do operations like copying something on the current document or copying something from other document to this current document. So the operation of copying and pasting is also available in the menu option, in the menu control. So some other features like copying, pasting, and the calling of specific panels and controlling overall animate environment can be seen under menu options. So under this option, you will find all these types of the commands for opening the document, for closing the document, for saving the document, for copying the document, for pasting the document, and for calling any particular specific panels. The tools panel. So this tool panel consists of various tools. This is the tools panel. As you see the figure 4.2, that is the tools panel. So the tools panel consists of various tools to draw, paint, select, modify objects in the workspace. And the tool panel is divided into four parts, as you can see. View, colors, and sections. So that's the upper part is the view part. So the upper part is the tool part, this is the view part, and the third one is the color part, and the fourth one is the options. The tool section. This tool section contains tools that are used for drawing, painting, and selecting objects. So all the tools related to the drawing you can find here. See the text tool, brush tool. Those are different types of brushes are there. Different type of the selection tools are there. So all the tools are available related for drawing in the tool section. Now the view section, it consists of tools for zooming and panning. This is the tools for zooming and this is the tools for panning. So the color section. The color section includes the modifiers to select the colors for the shape. Here this is the color section. You can see you can select different colors from here. You can set the background color and the foreground color using the color section. So this color section includes the modifier to select the colors for the shape you draw using different stroke and fill color picker. So here you will find the different stroke also, means the brush size also you can select. So the option selection, it displays the modifiers for currently selected tools. It displays the modifiers for currently selected tools. Modifiers affect the tools painting or editing operations. So all these things where you do the practical in this animation, when you create any animation, then you can see its different features. Now the shortcut key is used to insert a new frame is F5. Next to the timeline. You see this is a timeline. This timeline is a rectangular window that is present at the bottom of the stage. At the bottom of the stage you will find this timeline. It is the area where one controls the sequencing and timing of the graphics. Yes. So you can sequence the graphics and you can set the timing for the graphics, that for how many seconds it will appear on the screen. And it's a sequencing also when one graphics after another graphics will arrive on the screen over the stage. And other elements of the movie. The major component of the timelines are the layers, frames, and the playhead. These are the major components. This will discuss one by one. Layer, frames, and play. So first one, you see the frame. So animations in Animate are created with the help of the frames. So all animations are created with the help of the frames. frame is defined as the little rectangular cell. Frame is a little rectangular cell that appears on the timeline. Yes, on the timeline you will find the little rectangular cell, that is the frame. Every fifth frame displays a number. Every fifth frame you find a number here, as you can see. This picture is not clear, but in your book you can see it very clearly. So every fifth frame displays a number which you can find on the top of the timeline. Like films, anime document divides the length. So this anime document divides the length. So how many frames are containing here? So now see. Yes. So whole length of the time is divided into the frames. So frame displays the content of the movie. Yes, frame displays the content of the movie at a specific moment of time. So if this is the frame which contains the movie, which contains the content of the movie. So when you click on the frame, the content of that frame will be played. It will have the player. Keyframes. Keyframes are special types of frames where we define some change to an object's properties for an animation like position, color, shape, etc. And this a keyframe is represented by a solid black dot. We can easily change the length of a twinned animation by dragging a keyframe in the timeline. So this is a keyframe. Two types of keyframes are there. That is the keyframe with content and the empty keyframe. Keyframe which having some content and the empty keyframe. So this keyframe, where we define some change to the object properties, like where is what is position, its color. Suppose after 2 seconds the shape of this ball, if I want to change, after 2 seconds from green it will become red. So what we will do, we will drag it at the position of the 2 seconds and there will make it the red color. So when after 2 seconds the ball which is there, this color will be automatically changed. So there are so many things we can do. Not only color, we can change the shape also, we can change the position also. Yes, after 2 seconds we will put the position of this ball from this corner, left corner to the right corner here, and in 2 seconds it will travel this distance from here to from left corner to right corner, and when it will reach here and here we will change its shape. So from circle we can make it here rectangle, and this is some other things. So we can easily change the, so a keyframe is represented by a solid black dot. Yes, keyframe is represented by a solid black dot. So we can easily change the length of the twinned animation by dragging a keyframe in the line. In the timeline, yes, you drag the keyframe in the timeline and you can change its length of twinned animation. That's for what many seconds you want to see on the screen. Next, you see the layers. Layers are like transparent sheets stacked on the top of one another, each containing a different image that appears on the stage. Yes, layers means, as you can see here, as one is the background. And over that, suppose any other image you want to put, that is the second layer. And over the second layer, you want to write some content, that is the third layer. So layers are the transparent sheets. Transparent sheets are just stacked on top of one another, each containing a different image that appears on the stage. So all you can see it. So when we open a new animate document, it displays only a layer which contains its own timeline with endless frame. So whenever you open a new animate document, it displays only one layer. There is only current layer, one layer, three layer, and which contains its own. Every layer has its own timeline with endless frame. In one layer, you can add so many frames because the layer is going to contain the frames. So we can add more layers to organize the artwork. Yes. So we can add more layers of, as you can see, layer 1, layer 2, so that is highlighted one, the active layer. So we can add more layers to organize the artwork and animation in the document. We can draw and edit the objects on one layer without affecting the objects on another layer, because every layer is a different transparent sheet. Na? So If the sheet is different, so you can draw anything on any sheet. So it will not affect the other sheet. If I am drawing any image on the sheet 2, so why it will affect the sheet 1? It is not going to affect sheet 1 because I am working on sheet 2. Similarly here, if you are working on layer 2, so that working of layer 2 is not going to affect the working of layer 1. So the active layer is indicated with a keyframe navigation controller icon. This is the navigation controller icon, keyframe navigation controller icon. So one frame or other frame you can switch. Playhead. So this playhead indicates the current frame displayed on the stage. It is represented by a red frame. Yes, playhead is represented by a red frame. Here you can see the playhead. Indicates the current frame displayed on the stage, and it is represented by a red frame and a red vertical line below it in the timeline window. There you find the red vertical line also. It moves from left to right on the timeline as the movie proceeds through the frame. The speed of the playhead's movement is based on the frame rate setting. So its speed also you can increase or decrease with the help of the frame rate settings. If you increase the number of frame rate per second, so the speed will increase. Okay. Here you can see frame per second 24. So this setting you have to change. Next is the property inspector. The property inspector is a panel that displays the properties of the selected object. Yes. So whatever the object you have selected, whatever the layer, whatever the frame you have selected, its properties setting you can do in the property inspector window. This. The list of the properties also varies in the property inspector depending on the object selected, that what object you have selected. So it is not possible that every object has the same properties. So the properties displayed on the property inspector is depend on the object what you have selected. So you can make changes to the object or document attributes in the property inspector here. You can make its changes, its size and see so many, which are there, page, apply to the pasteboard. Now setting document properties, how you set the properties of the document. So each time when you open the Animate, the application opens a new file with the default settings for the movie properties, and we can create a new movie as we want. So to set the frame rate, background, color and ruler units, we use the following steps. So every time when you are going to open a new any Animate document, so it opens a new file with the default setting. Already some settings are there for the movie properties, but if you want to set the, if you want to do the modification in that settings, if you want to set the frame rate, if you want to set the background, if you want to change the color, if you want to change the ruler units, so how you change it? Click on the file, go on the new document dialog box is displayed. You see new document dialog box will display this way. Select the action script 3.0. Action script 3.0 you select. Okay. So define the stage dimension, ruler units and background. So stage area you can, dimensions you can declare. That what should be the stage dimension. And after that color, select the color, background color, frame rate and click on OK. Document will open with the defined settings what you have done. Okay. So this is all for today, students. In the next class we will discuss about the changing the settings of an already opened document. So thank you for your attention.